Hello and welcome to ShaunRayEdits. In today's video, I'm going to be showing you how to make your own awesome billboards just like this one. In this tutorial, we'll be going over the masking, the poster creation, making your own LED screen, and how to effectively composite it all to get a realistic looking billboard. There's also a shorter version of this tutorial available on my channel now. If you don't have your own footage, I've already gone and shot some for you, so let's get right into making this billboard. First, just bring your footage into After Effects and create a new composition with it. Next, we need to select the pen tool to create a mask to cut out the pre-existing advert on our billboard. I'd recommend taking your time to create a fairly precise cutout of your billboard advert here. Now that we have our mask, we just need to change it from add to subtract, so we're removing the advert and keeping all of the original footage of our billboard. Now, you may have some pixels bleeding through at the edges of your mask. You can either readjust your mask, or you can open up the mask tools and add a couple pixels on the mask expansion tab. This will slightly bloat the mask, allowing you to cover up those bleeding edges that you might have missed while masking. We now need to do some measurements to figure out the size of our billboard, since this is an irregular aspect ratio. To do this, we're going to open up the rulers, which can be found in the View tab or by pressing Command R. Next, just drag down from the ruler. This will create a blue line, which we'll be able to use to create measurements. We want to create a box that encapsulates our billboard so that we can figure out the rough dimensions of it to create a poster for it. Once we've got our blue lines, you can check and see where the blue line intercepts on our ruler, and then just take the two numbers and take the smaller number away from the bigger number, and this is going to be the size of our composition. For example, my vertical height is about 475 to 675, so that means that I've got a vertical height of 200 pixels. And my horizontal measurements are about 725 and 1375. This means my horizontal dimension is about 650. Now that we have the dimensions for our poster, we can start creating it in Photoshop. Or you can use After Effects if you want to create a live poster. To begin with, I'm going to alter my composition size to 650 by 200. You can always double both of these numbers if you want a higher resolution poster. Now that we have our canvas size, I'm going to begin designing. I'd recommend picking some colours that will complement the background in your billboard video. I'm just going to use assets from the poster for my previous video and just remodel them so that it fits my new billboard canvas. I've left a link to this video in the description. Make sure to check it out, there's some awesome techniques in there. Once you've created a poster that you're happy with, we just need to export the image and bring it into After Effects. Now that we have our poster, it's time to begin compositing. So just bring your poster into the composition and layer it underneath our original footage. And just reposition it so it's roughly in place of where our billboard is. Then we're going to go to the Effects and Presets tab and add the Mesh Warp effect. Now with the Mesh Warp, we're going to reduce the rows and columns down to 1 and increase the quality up to 10 to make sure that we get the maximum quality out of our billboard. Now we're going to take the four corners of our Mesh Warp and drag them to stretch into the four corners of our billboard. Now you can use the handlebars to make sure that your image is aligned with the borders of your billboard. Make sure not to drag them too far so that you don't accidentally stretch or bend your image. Now if your billboard is in a regular shape, like this one in Piccadilly Circus, you just need to increase the amount of rows or columns in your Mesh Warp. And by doing this, you'll be able to adjust your poster to the shape of your irregular billboard. Once you've completed your Mesh Warp, it should have your image looking like it's got the depth and rotation that it needs to actually be in the scene. But it still requires some extra compositing to make it look really realistic. To start with, we're going to create a fake LED screen to go over the top of the image. To do this, we need to create a new solid, which has also got a width of 650 and a height of 200. We're then going to change the colour of our solid and make sure that it's a dark to lightish grey. And with this solid, we're just going to adjust the position and rotation so that it's in line with our billboard. Once we're happy with the position of our solid, we need to place it underneath our original footage, but still above our billboard poster. Next, we need to go to the Effects and Presets tab, and then find the CC Ball Action effect and apply it to our solid. We're then going to adjust the grid spacing and change this down to about 1 or 2 depending on your scene. We're then going to alter the ball size down. I've gone for about 37, but you can play with this depending on how you want your billboard to look. Now we need to apply the Mesh Warp to our solid as well and stretch out so it fits the billboard the same way our poster does. And like the previous warp on our poster, I'm just going to reduce the rows and columns down to 1 and up the quality to 10. We then need to use the Mesh Warp to stretch the LEDs out to fit our billboard. I'd recommend taking care with this to make sure that the LEDs all look like they're properly aligned at the edges of the billboard. If any of your pixels are abnormally stretched, or they don't align properly and conform with the edges of the billboard, the viewer will be able to tell that the video is fake. To complete the LED look, we now need to create another new solid, which is also going to have the same dimensions, but this time it's going to be a complete white. Now drag this beneath our billboard, but keep it above our dark grey solid, and then copy the transform controls and paste them onto our white solid. And we're also going to copy and paste the ball action and mesh warp effect from our grey solid and paste it onto our new white solid. Now we just have to make two key adjustments to our white layer. We need to reduce the ball size down, so I'm going to reduce mine down to around about 15. And I'm also going to alter the position. So go to the transform controls, select the position, and then hit one arrow key to the left, and then one arrow key up. This means that our smaller white solid is just placed in the top left of our grey solid, and as you can see, it creates a much more realistic pixel effect than the grey on its own. And finally, just adjust the opacity on both of your solid layers to determine how much of the pixelated look you really want to stand out on your billboard. Now that we have a realistic looking LED screen, we need to add a glow and a flicker to it. So we're going to go to the Effects and Presets tab, and we're going to add the glow effect to our poster layer. Now we don't want this glow to be too abrasive, otherwise it won't match the scene. So I'm going to move the glow threshold up into the 90% range, and then I'm going to play around with the radius and intensity until I reach my desired look. And once you've found a look that you're happy with, you then just need to go through and change the glow threshold and add keyframes to it throughout your video to create an artificial flicker that will really sell the effect to the viewer. As you can see, I've added a bunch of different keyframes, just slowly tinkering with the glow threshold so that the glow on the billboard changes throughout the video. Now to help blend the billboard with the original footage, we're going to add a layer of noise. To do this, just create a new adjustment layer and move this adjustment layer to the top of your composition. Next, we're going to go to the Effects and Presets tab and add the noise effect to our adjustment layer. We're then going to increase the amount of noise to about 7 or 8% so that we've got a uniform layer of noise across the entire image. This is going to really help trick the viewer into believing your billboard is real. If your original footage is already noisy, you can just apply this to your billboard layers and match the noise that's already existing in your footage. The final trick to effectively compositing your poster is working on the color grade. To do this, we're going to swap from After Effects' standard view over to their color view. And in the Lumetri scopes, we're going to open up the vector scope. Now, when enabling and disabling my poster, I can see that it's adding a significant amount of blue, cyan, and green to my vector scope. I want to try and bring this more in line and closer to the color space that's already existing in my footage to help blend it better. To do this, I'm going to go to the Effects and Presets tab and add the Lumetri color effect to my poster. Make sure to move this to the top of your effects rack so it doesn't interfere with your mesh warp. Now in the Lumetri color effect, I'm going to start tinkering around with the blues and greens and try and bring them more in line with the rest of the footage. I'm going to be paying attention to the vector scope and trying to bring the colors into a more uniform color space, but without stripping all of the nice blues and greens that my poster possesses, just blending the colors better with my original footage. You can always add the Lumetri color effect to your original footage as well to try and help bring that closer to your billboard poster. Now I just need to give my footage one last color grade and then my footage is ready to be shipped. Thank you so much for watching. Let me know what you plan to put on your billboards in the comments. If you did enjoy this video, make sure to check out some of my other videos and maybe consider subscribing. See ya!